Hello, everybody. Welcome to Intermediate Accounting 17th Edition Video Solution Walkthrough. This is for Kiso, Wenget, and Warfield. This is exercise 19.3. Textbook authors are Don Kiso, Jerry Wenget, and Terry Warfield. The question used in the presentation is copyright 2019 by John Wiley and Sons. All rights are reserved. This is for educational purposes only. The video may not be distributed or redistributed without the express permission of Wiley. This solution presentation is copyright 2019 to 2022 by Bennett Tchaikovsky. All rights are reserved. The opinions contained within this presentation are those of Bennett Tchaikovsky and not the authors of the textbook or of Wiley. So the first thing I'm going to share with you is when it comes to these particular questions is that it has been a long time I've gone through and looked at deferred income taxes. And the one thing I will share with you, this is no offense to Wiley. Actually, I don't have access to Wiley's book. But the one thing I am going to share with you, though, is that I did go to Becker and I essentially studied their materials, which really helped me a lot. So when it comes to this particular section, I'm probably going to be going back and referring to the Becker materials. The other thing I will say is that some of the questions that are worded here in Wiley are a little bit funky. So it can be very, very helpful for you to have your solutions in front of you. But let's go ahead and take a look at exercise 19.3. So Bandung Corporation, beautiful name, by the way. Wow. Feels like I'm driving out to Santa Fe Springs, the Bandini Mountain, began 2020 with a $46,000 balance in the deferred tax liability account. At the end of 2020, the related cumulative temporary difference amount to $350,000, and it will reverse evenly over the next 2 years. Pre-tax accounting income for 2020 is $525,000. The tax rate for all years is 20%, and taxable income for 2020 is $405,000. Okay, so before we go anywhere, let's take a look at Ingrid's T accounts. Thank you, Ingrid. Let's take a look at Ingrid's T accounts. And I always say, let's look at this because it's the way you want to go on this question. So deferred tax liability, this is going to have a credit balance of $46,000. Okay, so this has a beginning balance on 1/1/20 of $46,000. Now, at the end of the accounting period, right, what is it? What should this balance be? Well, it tells us that we have the related cumulative temporary difference amounts to $350,000. Okay, so this is as of 12/31/20. This is going to reverse, though, evenly over the next 2 years at $175,000 each year. So what is this liability going to be? Meaning that what is the ending liability going to be? And you'll understand where I'm going with this in just a moment. So right over here, if these are my temporary differences, when I multiply this by 0.2, on an after-tax basis, my cumulative temporary differences are going to be over here at $70,000. So when I look at this question over here, the ending balance for this particular deferred tax liability account is going to be $70,000. And you're going to see why this is going to be important momentarily. Okay, so we've got this part out of the way. We've looked at the deferred, the timing, the temporary differences, right? So pre-tax accounting income for 2020 is $525,000. That's great. And the taxable income for 2020 is $405,000. This is the information I need. So over here for income taxes payable for 2020, I'm going to take my taxable income for 2020 of $405,000, or the favorite freeway where crazy stuff happens. I'm going to multiply this by my tax rate of 20%, and this is going to give me $81,000 as my income taxes payable current of $81,000. Okay. Now, here's where the fun part begins. As we look at this over here, so this is my income taxes payable. Now, the rest of it is not payable immediately. Why is that? Because it's deferred. Okay. So let's go through and do that now. Prepare the journal entry, record income tax expense, deferred income taxes, and income taxes payable. So what I'm going to do here is going to be a little bit different than the book solution, but let's go over here. And I think it's going to make a little bit more sense as we go through and do it this way. So my income tax expense current and my income taxes payable current is going to be $81,000, or the amount that's right over here. However, I have another item that's lingering around here, this 46 to 70 grand. 46,000 does not equal 70,000. So to make this balance, what am I going to need? I am going to need an adjustment here of $24,000. So I'm going to increase my deferred income tax liability by $24,000. And then what I'm going to do up here is I'm going to go ahead and debit income tax expense deferred. Or $24,000. Now, if you were to go through and look at the textbook solution, right, what is that textbook solution going to show? They're going to add up these two numbers and it's going to show income tax expense at 105. That's great. We're getting to the same number, but I'm explicitly showing it to you like this, is because I want us to make sure we know what portion is current and which portion is deferred. So right over here, prepare the income tax expense section of the income statement, beginning with the line income before income taxes. So let's go ahead and do that. So right over here, income income before income taxes. Now, here's where we're going to go through and use this number. Our income before income taxes is going to be $525,000. So the pre-tax accounting income, this is what I'm going to go through and use this. So 525 less income tax expense, current income tax expense deferred. So my current is 81. My deferred is 24,000. So my total income tax expense is going to be 105. And now you guys are going to be thinking, Tchaikovsky, you did write this question. Look at our ending magical number. So the net income is going to be 420. All right. Yeah, no, I'm just joking around. Maybe I'm not. Maybe I am. I don't really know. But this is how we go through and answer this first particular question in terms of going through and using deferred income taxes. Now, as I'm going through this, I've prepared with Becker, so I'm kind of using their materials more than Wiley. I know that might sound sacrilegious, but I'm going to tell you right now, for this particular section, I think that when you start going through and looking through these latter parts of intermediate accounting, and this is at least for myself, if you're taking this class, I'm assuming you want to become a CPA or you're really into to academic punishment. You know, so it's going to be one or the other. But I would start going through and using some sort of a CPA review course for certain sections. The reason why I'm also doing this too is that when it comes to going through and reviewing it, it's also going to be, at least for you, when you go to CPA review, it's going to say, oh, this looks fresh. So I don't really have to go through and do that much else. The other reason why I'm doing it is that there was some pronouncements that came out. I'm not saying the Wiley material is outdated, but I'm really kind of leaning more towards the Becker. Now, in terms of Becker's CPA review, this may sound like a commercial advertisement for Becker, but I am going to Hopefully I'm going to have a lot of fun giveaways to give away with Becker. And I'm also going to talk to Glime, Roger. I'm review, instruction, and different. It's about what's going to be best for you. And so there we go. And in any event, I want to thank you for being with me here today. I want to thank Wiley for allowing me to use their material and their content. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. It really helps out the channel and enables me to potentially offer you future deals. If you need future questions answered, please feel free to ask for it in the comments. Have a great rest of your day.